In this tutorial, I'll show you how to use the Dwarf II Ir Cut filter option to get the best images possible with the Dwarf II telescope. And doing so, you'll also get good looking sharp stars. If you don't have yet a Dwarf II telescope and you want to buy one, you can use the affiliate link in the description and the discount code GAM, which will give you a 5% discount on the price. I recently discovered that I was using the Dwarf II telescope settings wrong. And more exactly, I've been not using properly the IR cut pass settings options in the Dwarflab app. I think this is the most important setting in the Dwarf II app that was overlooked by everyone I know, including myself. And I think because it was set as default from the beginning, and everyone presumes that the IR pass option is enabled by default because it was properly tested and will always give us better images. Unfortunately, this is not true. The IR pass in many situations will boost the signal and allow the Dwarf II to capture more light, but in many situations this is not the case. Having the IR cut filter off and IR pass on by default is also responsible for all the Dwarf II images with bloated stars that just look bad. And if you check your images or the ones available on the Facebook community group, you can confirm that what I'm saying is correct. And I will show you in this video side by side this test to see the big difference that this filter settings makes and show you how to use it to get the best results possible with the Dwarf II telescope. Let's see first the advantage of having the IR pass enabled and IR cut filter off. Having IR pass on will allow infrared light to be captured by the imaging sensor of the Dwarf II telescope. Infrared waves have longer wavelengths than visible light and can pass through dense regions of gas and dust in space with less scattering and absorption. While this can have some benefits in boosting the light that the Dwarf II can capture in a single exposure, it has also a big drawback, and you will end up with images that look out of focus, blurry, and with bad looking stars. To solve this problem, you just need to enable the IR cut filter so the infrared light will be blocked, allowing the Dwarf II telescope to capture images with good focus and sharp stars. So if you want good looking stars and natural colors all the time in your images without spending time to process the images afterward, you can enable the IR cut filter all the time and go for longer integration times to compensate for the loss of signal caused by not allowing the infrared light to hit the sensor. Let's see first how to use the IR cut filter depending on what deep sky object you are imaging, and how to use it depending if you have also the Dwarflab UHC filter attached here on the telephoto lens, or you are imaging without any filters. In the first part of the tutorial, I will discuss the results obtained without using an external light pollution filter. Let's begin with star clusters. For these deep sky objects, it's best to use the IR pass disabled and the IR cut filter on. Doing so and blocking the infrared light will allow us to obtain astrophotography with sharp, good-looking stars and with better white balance. This is available even if you use external light pollution filters. And now let's see the results on Caldwell 14 double cluster. We can see here the two images captured with the Dwarf II, one having the IR cut filter off and the other with the IR cut filter on. These were single exposures, and now let's see also the two short live stacks with the IR cut filter off and on. And let's zoom in and check the stars a little bit. The image taken with the IR cut filter off and IR pass on is blurry, having large bloated stars that look out of focus. And the image captured with the IR cut on has good looking sharp stars that look rounder and more natural. So after doing this test on the C14 double star cluster, I think it's best to have the Ir Cut filter on all the time if you are imaging star clusters. Exceptions would be star clusters with dark nebula clouds, when the infrared light can help capture more signal. In this situation, you can use both options, and I'll show you how to do this later in the video. Now let's continue with galaxies without the UHC light pollution filter. We are now in Pixie Insight, and we have here the two short stacks of 3 minutes with the Andromeda galaxy, captured with the Dwarf 2. In the image to the left, I have used the default setting of IR pass, and in the second image, I used the IR cut filter on option. We can observe here also that the stars look much better and sharper in the image taken with the IR cut filter on, blocking the infrared light. So this allows the Dwarf 2 to focus better and get better looking stars with good focus. Let's measure also the stars using a measurement script. We will change now the image in grayscale, go to scripts, image analysis, full weight alpha maximum eccentricity, and click measure after click support. Here we'll show two graphs, and we will focus on the FWHM1, which will tell us how sharp are the stars, and we can see the number is around 5, which is a lot for a small focal length of 100 millimeters. I will use the same script on the image taken with the Ir Cut, and here we can see that the full width at half maximum number is smaller, under 4, which means the stars are in good focus, sharp, and not bloated anymore. This is also visible directly without using any scripts, and even more once we zoom in on both images. We can conclude again that the stars look much better with the Ir Cut filter on. However, we can observe also a decreasing signal without the infrared light hitting the sensor. In order to capture more signal and have also sharp stars, we need to use both options, Ir pass on and Ir cut on. We can make a short live stack of a few minutes with the stars, then make a secondary longer live stack with the Ir pass on. Here we are interested in obtaining for each stack a starless image and a star mask with the sharp stars. Once we have done this step, we can use the star mask of the sharp stars on the starless image that was taken with the Ir pass option and has better signal. This will allow us to obtain the best image possible using only the advantages of these two options, Ir cut on and Ir pass on. And here we can see an example of 2-hour stack with Andromeda galaxy. The first image was captured with Ir pass on, the second image is Ir pass combined with the stars of the 3 minutes exposure with Ir cut filter on. It is a big difference, and is very clear how sharp the secondary image looks compared with the first one. And finally, this is the final image after I adjusted also the white balance. Now let's move to the next test on Messier 81 and 82 galaxies. Here is very clear that having the Ir pass on will give us better results on the two galaxies. And to get also the sharp stars, I recommend the same workflow as I mentioned above, to use a star mask of the image stack obtained with the Ir cut filter on, or to use the image in Photoshop or other software with a blending mode like screen, so it will blend the sharp stars on the starless image layer below. Now let's continue with nebulas without the UHC filter. This is our third category of deep sky objects, and let's see what are the test results. Without any external filter, I have imaged Messier 42, the Orion Nebula, and Running Man Nebula. First with the Ir pass enabled, and after with the Ir cut on. Looking at the two images side by side, we can see in the left image, captured with Ir pass, more light, especially into the reds, compared with the image captured with Ir cut on. A small difference in the Running Man Reflection Nebula, and more visible in the Orion Nebula. The Ir cut filter looks a little sharper and has sharper stars as expected. I think that with the air pass filter we capture more light, but I like the image with air cut on more because it's sharper and the stars look much better. Let's take a fast look also at the dark reflection nebula Messier 78. In the stack from the left part of the screen captured with air pass, we can see clear a bigger improvement in signal, and more light is visible in the nebulosity region, especially around the dark nebula clouds. And comparing the image with the air cut filter on, from the right part of the screen, I can say here that air pass makes a big difference. My conclusion on this test using the Dwarf 2 without any filters, I think that the air pass filter is still the best option to use as default. However, to be able to get sharp stars, you need to use also the air cut option and make a secondary short life stack that you can use it later to blend the stars. Now let's continue with the second part of the video, imaging nebulas with the USC filter from Dwarflab attached to the telescope. Now we can see clear that using the USC filter makes the decision very easy on what option we should use. And looking at both images with the Orion Nebula captured with the USC filter from Dwarflab, the image captured with the air cut internal filter on is by far the best image. Everything looks better and much sharper from the nebula dust lens to the stars. Also, the Running Man nebula looks better with the air cut filter on. Now let's see why the air pass option is not longer so effective when we use filters with the Dwarf 2 smart telescope. I think the reason is because the USC filter is letting only part of the infrared light to pass through and blocking the rest. Most of the light pollution filters will allow the visible light to pass up to 700 nanometers, where the infrared spectrum starts from about 700 nanometers. This means that these filters will let through just a small portion of the infrared light, which makes the option of air pass not so useful anymore. However, looking at the Dwarflab USC filter bandpass graph, I believe this filter was made especially for the Dwarf 2 telescope. And it does let more of the infrared light to pass compared with other filters. Even so, the amount of infrared light captured by the sensor is less than without the USC filter. So if we take the filter off, we'll capture more infrared light. Getting good focus with infrared light is more difficult, and if we have also the USC filter attached, the focus will change even more, generating blurry images with large bloated stars. Now let's take a look at the two images also without the stars, captured with the air cut on and air pass. It's very clear that the image taken with the air cut filter on has sharper details, and the nebulosity is more defined with some nice details visible in both Messier 42 and 43. Compared with air pass image, which is very blurry. And to be sure, I repeated the test a few times with air pass option, and the results were the same. Now let's see how the short stack of 5 minutes of integration time taken with the air cut filter looks like after processing the image in PixInsight and Adobe Photoshop. Even if we need a longer integration time with the Dwarf 2, I was able to obtain a nice looking image with the Orion Nebula with sharp details and nice color. Regarding the color balance, it seems easier to recover the blues from the image taken with the air cut filter, and this helps also to process the image faster. My legs. Now let's see a 2 hours older stack with the Orion Nebula that was combined with the stars taken with the air cut filter. Having also sharp stars makes a huge difference and is allowing us to get better astrophotography images. To be sure the tests were accurate, I tested the second night again, having the USC filter attached to the telescope. Like this. The results were similar, testing on the Orion Nebula the night before, but this time I used 10 minutes integration image stacks. And took also a longer life stack of 26 minutes with the Ir Cut filter on. Same as before, the Orion Nebula looks much better with the Ir Cut filter enabled. The nebula clouds are crisp and the stars look small and sharp. I changed after the target and imaged the California Nebula. On this emission nebula, Ir Cut on is also the winner. We have sharp stars and similar signal in the nebula. After I decided to test also on a star cluster with nebulosity, Messier 45 the Pleiades, having also the filter on. Usually we image without, but I kept the filter, the USC filter on for this test, and the image looked much better with the Ir Cut filter. Before ending the test, I wanted also to see the results on IC434, Horsehead Nebula and Flame Nebula. This is a beautiful nebula region in the Orion constellation that contains an emission nebula, a dark nebula, and also a reflection nebula. The results here were different. Using the IR pass option, I had a better signal. The infrared light did pass through the dark nebula clouds and was captured by the sensor. From this result, we can see that IR pass will work better on dark nebulas or emission nebulas that are surrounded by these dark nebula clouds. And here the Ir Cut filter will not allow all the light to be captured by the telescope camera sensor. After testing the Ir Pass option and Ir Cut with the Dwarf 2 while using the USC filter on nebulas, I believe when having the USC filter attached, it's best to change from the default Ir Pass to the Ir Cut enabled. This will give you the best results for emission and reflection nebulas, except dark nebulas and emission with dark nebula clouds, where the infrared light will allow more light to be captured by the Dwarf 2. On these nebulas, you can make a short stack for the stars and change after to Ir Pass for the longer plan and combine with the stars later to obtain a better image. In conclusion, knowing when to use the Ir Cut and Ir Pass options will allow you to get the best results with the Dwarf 2 telescope. Without an external light pollution filter, you can still use the default option Ir Pass for the long plans, but use first the Ir Cut option and make a short stack. This will give you sharp stars that you can combine later with the other image. If you do not want to process the images after, you must decide between sharp stars with Ir Cut on or extra light captured with Ir Pass. When using an external filter like the Dwarflab USC, you will image mostly nebulas. And here for most of the situations, using the Ir Cut will give you the best results, except for dark nebula clouds. I hope you find this tutorial useful and it will help you to get the best images with the Dwarf 2 smart telescope. Do like and share the video if you enjoyed watching. I am sharing also the best data captured with the Dwarf 2 on the channel membership sharing folder, available for the Nebula plan along with my other astrophotography. So be sure you check also the channel membership out if you are interested to get access to my astrophotography data. If you do not have yet a Dwarf 2 and you want to buy one, you can use the affiliate link in the description and the discount code, which will give you a 5% discount when buying the Dwarf 2 smart telescope. I hope this tutorial will help you get better results, and I'll see you in the next video. Until next time, clear sky.